Still the raging storm in me.
Praise the Lord. I want to say a pleasant good night to each and everyone on the outside. Your truly brother Edwin, and I have a special guest with me tonight, my fellow Jamaican bishop, apostle
Powell,
and I have brother Jai Paul passing through for 2 minutes, just come and drop him off. So we just want to give God all the glory. Everything we do, we must put him first. So right about now, I will let Pastor Powell introduce himself and open with a word of prayer tonight.
Amen. Bless you. It's a pleasure to be in the studio. As you said, introduce myself. Introducing already the Apostle Bishop Vincent Powell from Jamaica, Port Antonio, from the United States of Port Antonio, Jamaica. Amen. Let me pray for God's divine direction for this program. On this segment this afternoon. Gracious Father, I praise you. I honor you for this wonderful occasion to bring the word across to this nation. I give you the glory, I give you the praise. Bless this man of God. This brother is about to enter into this program. We ask for your divine direction and your anointing to rest upon this program. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That men and women will come to know the knowledge of our Savior Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, do a work over the airwave. In Jesus' name, I apply the blood over the airwave right now. And I release the God, the hand of the Lord, to encamp over around this airwave. That the word go forth with power and authority. That counseling will go forth with accuracy. Now I give you thanks and I give you praise in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen. So I just want you to call a friend and tell a friend to tune in to Choice Radio 92.9. We are on the web. We are on the phone line. The phone line is 213-493-0146. Just call a friend and tell them to tune in, because something good will be happening tonight. And you will be blessed with one word. Amen? Praise the Lord.
You've heard us sing a lot about being a friend of God. Just one more song. Would you lift a hand and just say, Lord, you've been a friend. I can testify about it. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for all you've done through your Son. Thank you for all you do. You brought me through when I look around and see.
Exaltation,
power,
blessing,
yes,
worship,
love without end, you've been a friend. Ooh.
Oh, thank you, Jesus.
It's not a friend like
Stacy Joseph said,
for protecting me.
Yeah.
what a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. All we have to do is take it to the Lord in prayer.
Praise the name of the Lord.
So go tune in now to your van. Go tune in.
Yeah. Yes. So, Pastor Powell, God is good to us.
Yes, and he's happy to be with us, with you today. Yeah, man. Bless you. Bless you. Bless you. Man.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah. Amen. Bless you.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, I know it was a tremendous day in service this morning.
Yeah, I really do enjoy.
And each and every one of us that was there, we bless, because the Holy Spirit was in the building this morning.
Yes.
And you bring a powerful message, and it touched a lot of us heart.
Mm. What was the subject of the message today?
The subject of the message today with Isaiah.
We did it anointed.
Anointed, yes. Yes, but he was good. He was really good. Okay. Yeah, so just go ahead and tell the people about you a little more.
All right. As I said before, Apostle Bishop Powell from Jamaica. I'm very happy to be in this country to minister the word of the Lord through a gentleman by the name of Pastor J. Paul. Bless the Lord, and happy for his connection to your church.
Amen.
And I came there last week Sunday, and I observed, and understand I will be speaking today this week. So I began to see the Lord, and his presence came over me so much, and really it was dealing with me concerning the congregation. So I come there very open today.
Yeah.
And therefore, based on what you see happen today, my mind was open to the Holy Spirit. So they did come there prepared to do all of that and to lay and to anoint. Yeah. But the Holy Spirit moves in that direction to anoint your bishop and another person. But as the Lord was saying, that he called Moses,
yes,
to be the leader.
Yeah.
And you cannot have two leaders. You cannot have two head and one body.
That's it.
Right. And today I want to share with us in a little while when we finish with this discussion. I want to go into the word in Psalms 24. So I'm going to ask our guests out there to tune in, listening, and can call in.
Yeah,
for advice later on, counsel, praise God, and for prayer. Amen. I'm going to speak a word in this region. Speak a word to the city of New York. And God have given me a word to broad foot to the city of New York. God is with his people. Don't get me wrong. God is with his people. But there's going to be a shaking in New York. There's going to be a visitation from the Most High God. Hallelujah. Amen. God going to move mighty by his power. Something is on the horizon. And the Lord has sent me in this city, in this country, to speak forth his word. But to the believers, Brother Edwin, to God's people, this is a word I bring now, to God's people, those who have intimate relationship with him, those who build with him. In Psalms 24, verse is 9. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, even lift them up, ye everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. The last verse said, who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. The Lord of hosts is a King of glory. This Jesus Christ himself introduced himself in the heart of Hell Gate and said, listen, I am the Lord of hosts that show up. Mean is Lord of War, which means is Jehovah Sabaoth. So I'm going to talk about Jehovah Sabaoth in 2 minutes. Jehovah Sabaoth. Those who are listening, say it with me. Jehovah Sabaoth. Amen. God of War. Do you know that the God that we serve, the God of Israel, is a God of War? And you have not lost a battle. I'm here to tell God's people who are going through some kind of warfare in their lives, in their marriage, at their workplace, wherever. I want to let you know this afternoon, I release the anointing of Jehovah Sabaoth upon you. He come to defend you. He come to war for you. Because you stand for him, so he's going to stand for you. Amen. Am I right, brother?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He will stand for those who stand for him.
Yes.
He will lift up those who lift him up.
Yeah.
He will magnify those who magnify him. Because you see, worship is a two-way thing. When you worship and send up the praise, the blessing will come down.
Yes.
It's a two-way thing.
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
So what go up, things will come down.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. So the Bible declared about a man by the name of Joshua. Joshua was fighting a battle. And my brother, the battle gets intense. Very, very intense. In so much that Joshua about to lose the war. He's about to lose the war. Because why? Darkness was coming in. Night was coming down. And therefore, if night come down, Joshua discerned that he's going to lose the war. And Joshua cannot afford to lose the war. So Joshua look up. He cannot afford darkness to come down on him. He look up and he command the sun to stand still. And my brother, the sun stood still. And Joshua fight the battle. Praise the name of the Lord. Joshua fight the battle. I'm here to tell somebody this afternoon that God is about to fight your battle. Yes, my brother and my sister. Yes, that battle that you're fighting, you cannot make it on your own. The battle is the Lord's. Yes, he's about to fight your battle. Surrender that battle to the Lord, Jehovah Sabaoth, and he will fight your battle. He will win your battle. Guess what? I love this part. He will fight your battle for you and you win it. You never heard that before? Yeah. He will fight your battle and you, the one, will win it. You ever heard about the scripture that says in Romans chapter 8, somewhere there? He said, all things work together for good to them that love the Lord and who have the call of God. Watch this. Two words I'm going to take out of that verse of scripture. The two words is good and glory. All things work together for good to them that love God.
Amen.
Watch this now. The glory belongs to God. Two words there. The glory belongs to God, and the good belongs to us. All things work together for good. The good, whatever happened in your life, God is after your good. He may look away presently, and things is uncomfortable, and you wonder, what is this, Lord? You wonder, what is going on in my life? Praise God. God, why you allow this to happen? God allow it to happen. Why? He want to work out your good. He's running after your good. So what the devil meant for your bad, God turn it around for your good. What the devil meant for your bad, God turn it around for your good. Hallelujah. So the good is for you, brother, and the glory is for the Lord. We cannot swap it. We cannot take God's glory. The glory belongs to God, and the good belongs to us. All things work together for good to them that love the Lord. Amen. So Joshua was also fighting this battle when he come on his son to stand still. In one point in time, Joshua saw an angel with a drawn sword, 1 foot on the waters, one on the earth. When Joshua see that tall man with a drawn sword, Joshua said, "Who are you?" Joshua said, "Who are you? Are you for us? Are you are against us? Are you on our side or are you on the enemy's side? Which side are you on?" For you can see this tall man with the sword draw. That's the Lord of hosts. The man that he spoke with, he says to him, "I'm neither on your side or their side. I am the captain of the host." That's the Lord of war. Lord of hosts. The captain of the host is Jesus Christ. Brother and sister, surrender your battle in the hands of Jehovah God. He is the man of war. And anything he fight, any war he fight, he never lose. When the Lord goes into battle, tell me who can stand against his awesome might.
No one. No one.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yeah. So that's the subject I want to deal with this afternoon. People are going through the personal problem or fighting some battle. Brother, I want them to know this afternoon to let God fight the battle. Just give it up. Yeah, just give it up the Lord.
The battle is not theirs.
Go again.
I said the battle is not ours.
Not
the
ours. The battle is the Lord. Battle. Right. And Jehovah Sabaoth means Lord of War. And end time Jehovah Sabaoth, when you're in the difficulties by the government or document papers or problem, whatever problem, just call on Jehovah Sabaoth to fight that war. Let him release angel to go in the office, amen, and find some papers that some demons in the office, amen, hiding your document. Hallelujah. I come to lose some people here this afternoon. Korabasete. Lose some people, amen, that their document have been tied up. Hallelujah. And some demons in the office, amen, hide your papers, and those are in authority looking, searching for your paper to release you and cannot find your document. Amen. Demons tie up your paper. I come to bring you deliverance, that the Lord of War, Jehovah Sabaoth, will release his mighty warfare angel into those offices, into those places, and to dig up and to find your papers. Open the eyes of the secretary, open the eyes of the supervisor, open the eyes of those who are in charge to find your paper. Sometimes somebody in the office sit and cover it up. It's the demons working through that person. Don't want to let you go. But in Jesus' name, I command your paper. I'm talking to somebody this afternoon. I command your paper to be released. I command your paper to be released. I release Lord of hosts, Jehovah Sabaoth, to fight on your behalf. Praise God. We're going to leave. Find a warfare song for me. Amen. You can find a song. Because I want to release something here this afternoon. Praise God. We're going to wake up the city of New York.
So before I do this one, I'm gonna play this one for you.
Okay. Yeah. Come on. That's the song.
Yes, Jesus. When he promised to do something, he will do it.
I promise to take care.
Oh yeah.
Of all his children. when they're going through some rough times in their lives. When it seems that all around has fallen, yeah, and the devil tells you you cannot win, only believe, put your faith and your trust in the Lord. He will deliver right on time before the day. Find the answer. God will come through for you. You've been praying for deliverance, but His words give assurance. Before the day's over, God will come through for you. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. So whenever you are faced with your problems, yeah, just give them to Jesus. I know He'll lift your heavy burden. Hallelujah. He's a faithful friend. Those who love and trust Him, oh thank you Lord, there is nothing too hard for my God to do. Oh, He's a mighty God, the Prince of Peace. There is no one like the Lord. Remember, there's a bond.
Oh yes, if you want the deliverance, if you want prayer, you could call the station, or the studio, 347-663-8638, and Pastor Powell number in Jamaica, 1-876-475-3847, because he will be leaving soon. I gotta call on the line. Hallelujah. Good night, caller.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Glory to His name. This is Pastor Jai Paul. I'm enjoying the service. It's sounding good, real good on the outside, and the teaching is excellent. The teaching is excellent. So I go and sit back in my driving seat.
All right.
And listen to the message.
Praise the Lord.
Thank you.
All right.
All right, you're welcome.
Bless you, Rev.
I'm here listening, sounding real good.
All right.
And I have you on in Jamaica also.
Okay, well, that's cool. That's nice.
I have you on in Jamaica, so people in Jamaica are hearing you right now.
All right.
All right.
Yeah, so you'll give her the number so they could call in.
Okay.
All right.
He said he what in Jamaica?
As long as Jesus, I think he provide me know.
So we're live in Brooklyn, we're live in Jamaica.
All right.
All over the world, we're right over.
In the morning,
morning,
and I see the sun rising.
Rising.
You know me, I say thank him.
Thank him.
Proud of people make me crown him.
Crown.
What a man full of blessings.
Blessings.
Everybody make me crown him.
Crown.
From the east, west, north, and south, all about. Everybody jump and shout me.
So if you know you're blessed tonight, and if you know anything holding you down, you've been in bondage for a couple years and you want a release, the pastor could pray for you. But if you don't believe, you wouldn't get out of it. You gotta believe.
In the morning,
morning,
and I see the sun rising.
You gotta have this faith.
Thank him.
Isn't it?
It's right. It's right.
What a man
yeah.
Full of blessings. Everybody make me crown him.
Crown
from
him.
The east, west, north, and south, all about. Everybody jump and shout and sing.
My, it's awesome. And every time, there's a song that I love to sing. Every time I turn around, God is blessing. Since I've been, Brother Edwin, since I've been here, really enjoy the city of New York. And I must send shout out greetings to Bishop Pastor Shelton of the Tabernacle of Praise Worship Center. Praise the Lord. And send greetings to the pastors and officers and apostles and bishops in this region, in the city of New York, and those who are laboring in the vineyard. We want to say greetings and amen and pray for those who are laboring in the vineyard. We want to just big them up and give God thanks for all the leaders of the churches who are laboring in the vineyard. Sometimes it's not pretty, it's not nice. Amen. So we pray their strength. And at this time, in the same breath, I was here in New York here a couple weeks, last 2 weeks, at a conference, prayer breakfast conference. They were all united. We were praying for these girls that were all hostage in Nigeria.
Yeah.
So we are there. And we want to also pray for them tonight also. We want to lift them up in our prayers. Amen. We want to lift up our women, our society. We want to lift up our churches in this region. That the gates of hell, the Bible already prophesied. Jesus Christ prophesied that the gates of hell shall not perish, shall not prevail. And therefore, we're going to stand upon the word of God. And therefore, the church will not perish because the gates of hell shall not prevail. So the church will not perish. The church will not go under. The church shall go over in the city. There's going to be a mighty shaking in the city of New York.
Yes. You was talking about you have a branch in Maryland or something like
that? Yeah, we have a branch in Maryland, not too far from Baltimore. I think it's in the I've been to Baltimore, but in the Silver Spring area too. Yeah, somewhere there. Yeah, we had in Jamaica, about 5-6 branches in Jamaica. In fact, those are listening to us live now in Jamaica. Hi, greetings, especially those in Port Antonio area. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And we are very live tonight from the studio of New York. Amen. And I just come to bring God blessing. I don't come to condemn and preach judgment message. Amen. If the Lord's a judgment, well, it's judgment. Hallelujah. But God said there's going to be a shaking in this city.
Yes.
Amen. And God's going to protect his chosen people. As I said before, Lord of War, Jehovah Sabaoth, is going to war for his people. It's warfare time. And asking the church and pleading to the churches to buckle up, get ready, equipped. Amen. We're going to fight like a soldier. Amen.
But you see, in this season now,
yeah,
we have to be on a mission to pray more hard for this country and for the nation, for the whole world.
Yeah.
Because the time coming now is coming close. And we need a lot of praise.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So, you know, praise move mountain.
So what you say is that this is a season that the church must enter into intense of prayer.
Yeah.
Intense of prayer. Those who are praying, let me say it again. Those who are praying once a day, start praying 2 times. Those who are praying 3 times a day, start praying 4 times. Double your prior effort.
Because when I am walk, I just because I do me a mechanic and underneath the vehicle walking, and sometimes I'm singing and I'm praying. And
right.
The boss and them is Muslim, so we become Muslim, stop and pray.
Mm-hmm.
When they see 12 o'clock, they stop, they shut down, but you know. So why we Christian cannot do that?
Yeah.
Yeah, we could do that.
If your employer, your boss is a Muslim, when you see him cut and gone do his prayer, you break off and still away do your prayer.
Yeah, well, what I just do, right through the day, I give him God praise.
Yes, that's
and,
right.
And I have my gospel praying. I mean, playing. Most of the time, you know, in the early days, they didn't used to hear. They used to turn it off. And I used to say, Lord, why are they doing that? I say, Lord, I leave everything to you. Because you have another guy. He is not a Christian. He play, well, two of us have a radio. I have mine on one side. Yeah, mm-hmm. He's on this side. So he turn up here on loud.
Oh, God.
So you can't hear me gospel. And you know, a couple of weeks ago, he come to me and he say, you see this kind of music I play? That's the other guy. Mm-hmm. He say, you see, I don't want to hear this music no more. I want to hear this music. That's the gospel music.
That's the gospel.
I say, praise the Lord. I say, my prayers work.
Yeah.
You understand?
Amen. Your prayers work, right?
Yeah.
Prayers work.
Sometimes the boss and them used to just come and, that music too loud.
Mm-hmm.
I say, why? And, you know, I say, okay. I go and I turn it down because I get kind of high and I do supposed to get high. Mm-hmm. But I say, let me leave the bottle to God.
Yes.
And no. Everybody want to hear the gospel.
Amen. Amen. And that the Muslim person?
Yeah.
Hmm?
Yeah.
He said don't want to hear his music, he want to hear yours gospel.
Yeah.
Amen. You see, there's power in the gospel.
Oh yes.
There's power
in the name of Jesus.
Yes, there's enough power in the gospel in Jesus' name. Praise God. Whether in singing or in preaching, in testifying, there is enough power in the gospel.
Oh, yes.
To save anyone.
Anyone.
Hallelujah.
You know, so we have to give God thanks and praise for the littlest thing what deserve. Because he deserves all the glory, all the honor.
Yeah, he deserves it.
Oh, yes.
He deserves it.
Hallelujah.
So I want you to understand, those who are listening, that the scripture thoughts for this evening program, we're going to rest on that scripture for the balance of the night. This is the scripture thought for this week, Sunday, in Psalms 24 and verses 9 and 10. So look it up. Go to it. That's the scripture thought for this evening. You can call, give a call about it. Praise the Lord. That is Psalms 24 and verses 9 and 10. Amen.
Maybe you're going through a storm in your life, wondering, will I make it through? All you have to do is ride out your storm.
You've been in the storm.
Feel free to call. The number to call is 777-663-8638.
Nights of
remember, is your life, your salvation is your choice.
Have been so long. Your ship has lost anchor, and the storm's got you drifting. Your night's almost over. You can ride out your storm. Ride out your storm. God is there with you. You may not feel him. You're not alone. Oh, but your morning is coming.
Yes, sir.
Just hold on to Jesus and ride out your storm. Just remember God's promise.
Yes, sir.
I'll never leave.
That's what he said.
Though the waters are raging, they'll do you no harm.
Thank you, Jesus.
Don't give up the battle, for your answer is coming. Just hold on to Jesus and ride out your storm. Oh, ride out your storm. God is there with you.
Yes, he is. Yes, he is.
You may not feel him. Your morning is coming. Just hold on to Jesus and ride out your storm. Your morning is coming.
All you have to do,
just hold on to Jesus and ride out your storm.
He's right there with you.
He's right there with you.
He promised to never leave you.
He'll never leave you.
You can ride out your storm.
Oh yes, you can ride out your storm tonight if you're going through this hard battle.
Though I speak.
Oh yes, let me just interact for a little bit again.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Pastor Powell,
when we were off the air, we were sharing your testimony. It's an awesome testimony for the public to know. I never know you were the DJ.
You're doing the gospel. I'm doing the gospel.
Gospel, now. Praise the Lord. And up you know that God is saving. God is saving a lot of DJs around the world.
Yes.
Praise the Lord and rap singers. Yes. Amen. But guess what, man of God? Guess what? Let me share this with you. That when God save you, and do not take away your talent, he do not take away your dance, he only change your dancing floor. The place you used to dance anymore. Yeah. Place you used to go, you go there anymore. Amen. So what you have, the talent you have, you're going to use it for God's glory.
Yes, but not the owner of the station too. We was out in the world there doing our thing. And same as how, and this man I'm telling about it, he crazy for God.
Yeah.
I tell you, he crazy more than me for God.
Where is he now?
He home. He listening.
Oh my God. Bless you. Bless you. Thanks for listening. Call in, please.
Brother Foster.
Brother.
I'm Minister Foster.
I'm in your studio. Please call me in. Please call in, sir.
You, this man is on fire. When tell the fire, you know how fire hot.
Yeah.
And he is on fire. So, as I'm saying, we was out there doing our stuff. And the other day, I come on this, in the studio and I say, well, you know, enough is enough. Sometimes I play the music, the volume music, and I didn't also feel it no more. And I told him, and he said the same thing to me, to brother, the same thing I just do. So I say, okay. So I come and I say, well, no more volume music. And I give my heart to the Lord, and I have a church going. So I say, anybody who want to join us, they could. I get a bus, I hire the bus, I pay the bus in my money. And I full up the church. Every Sunday, I invite people and I bring in people.
Making discipleship,
And making discipleship.
Yes.
And happen.
Wonderful.
Well, I still in church. I ain't give up. I still doing. I'm driving the bus for the church now.
So what's the name of the church?
Kingdom Builders of Sanctuary.
Kingdom Builders
Sanctuary.
Sanctuary.
Yeah, that's KBS.
KBS, Kingdom Builders Sanctuary. Let me say shout out to the Kingdom Builders Sanctuary brethren, those who are listening, and Elder
Robert.
Yeah. Amen. Greetings to all of you and the elect lady, First Lady. Yeah. Praise God and love you all. And it was wonderful to fellowship at that congregation there today.
Yes. So as I do that, and we're still going strong, you know.
Yes.
And God is good.
Amen.
Keeping me, and you know, I'm doing just what I do, what I could do, but I have more to do.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
So I just give him thanks and praise so for keeping me and making me strong, and do not faint in the going.
Yes. And happy to know that young man, you give up for the Lord. In First John said, young men, I write unto you, young man, because you're strong.
Yes.
You overcome the world. The word of God abided in you. Praise God, and happy to know in the youthful days, amen. You know, we tell turn old when you and the use for God, you can go on the battlefield for God, amen. You have the strength and figure for God. Yes. People out there, do not wait to come hold you, give it up to God, amen. Give it to God now when you're young, amen. May God get the glory out of your life,
amen.
It's like orange, right? It's like orange, they cut the orange and they suck out the juice. Yeah, suck up the juice. And then come that's old. They will come whole now. They give God the what left.
Oh, right.
What left.
Yes.
Right. No, give God your juice.
Amen.
Come on, give God your juice, somebody.
Hallelujah. But that wasn't all too. And you know what really drew me closer to God more? A couple of years ago, Well, when I was back in my country, yeah, you know, I baptized over there.
Wait, that's
right. Grenada.
Grenada, okay.
Yeah. And me and this guy, about six or seven of us get baptized. And each and every one of us left the church. And me and this guy, we was real close. We used to do things together. Mm-hmm. And I left on a travel. And I left him home. Still, he out in the world, I out in the world here too. And, you know, in the sleep, I got a vision, a dream. And he came to me and told me he need a glass of water. So I give him the glass of water. And he tell me, where he there? Don't come. So I say, where you there? He say, he there in hell. So I jump up in the sleep. And the morning I call home, I call my sister and, she, and I tell her the dream I had.
Mm-hmm.
And she tell me the man died 3 days ago.
So and you never know that he died.
No, I never know.
And you got the dream. That dream alone. All right, put the Bible one side. Some people don't believe in the Bible. Put the Bible. Watch this now. That dream alone is a witness to the Bible. It's confirmation.
Yeah.
If you die as a sinner,
yeah,
without God and Christ, your place is hell.
Yeah.
And that's the truth.
Yeah.
And that's the truth. And we don't have any more truth. That's the truth. You're on the way to hell. And I'm here to tell somebody, stop. Turn around. Repent. Yeah. The word repent means to stop. Turn around, yeah. Praise the Lord. Change your way and mend your way. Praise God. And you get that dream. You never know that he died.
No, I never know because he went in St. Lucia, and as far as I learned, he was drunk and a car lick him down and kill him on the spot. He didn't even say, well, so if you're drunk, you can't say, oh God, help me. Mm-hmm. Okay, you're done drunk already.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're not conscious.
Yeah.
So if you repent, you're unconscious.
Nope.
You're not conscious. Okay? So that repentance is like it out of emotion. You're not conscious.
Yeah.
You're not sober.
Sober.
And the fact that you're having water, you was have a bottle of water.
A glass of water.
Okay.
Give him a glass of water. Tell me you want a glass of water. Because how he come? He come like, he clothes rugged on him and he like real tired. You understand? He's tired, and so I see. When I give him the glass of water, because you know, I give him the glass of water, and we're talking,
mm-hmm.
And he tell me, "Where he there? Do not come there." I say, "Wow." So when I really, you know, but still, I in the world still. I didn't really check it, but when I get to my senses,
mm-hmm.
I could have died, and go in the same place where he come.
Yes, yes.
Because he come and want me,
mm-hmm.
and I didn't take it, but God had a purpose for me.
Yes.
Nothing happened before his time.
He's telling that way he's don't come there.
Yeah, don't wait, come there.
But it's written in the Bible. It is said in the Bible that it was the rich man.
Yeah, and
right? And I think he said that I can't come where you are. There's a gulf. I can't come. I can't reach where you are. So your dream is lined up with the Bible, with the word of God.
Yes.
The dream lined up with the word of God. Right? If you're in hell, you can't walk over to heaven.
Nope.
Is one way in to hell.
Yeah.
When you get in, one way in, one way in, and no way out. One door in, and no way out. Praise the Lord.
Praise
so therefore, when you get into hell, you cannot come out. And listen to me, and those who are listening, in hell is hot. In hell, there is no bad juice. There's no
ice water.
Ice water. There is no suck. There is no ice cream. No fridge.
Nothing.
To keep you cool down there.
Pure water.
No icy. My God, it's hot. Amen. I want to spend my long eternity with Christ.
Amen.
Christ is the door. He said, I am the door, the truth, and the life. It's a wonderful testimony, brother. Wonderful testimony. I'm very pleased of you in this. Amen. Office. Amen. In this. Amen. Ministry that you have. I'm very happy for you and the ability and the talent that you have and giving God glory out of your talent.
Oh, yes.
I'm very pleased of you and that you'll win others to come, making disciples. Praise the Lord. I'll be here for a few days. Next week I'm gone. Praise God. But I'll be back shortly. I'll be working with you, working with the church here in New York, doing what I can do for the city of New York, bringing souls to the kingdom.
Hallelujah.
Amen. So people feel to call me and my Jamaican number. We have also prayer line over there. Praise the Lord. Again, I am Apostle Bishop and Bishop Powell from Jamaica. Praise the Lord. I'm here until next week. Amen. But this Jamaican number, you still can get me here because the number you can call anywhere.
Okay, you forward it, okay.
Right.
It's 1-876-475-3847. That is Bishop Powell number. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I thank God I've made Jesus my all in all. From now on his name I'm surely gonna call. And if I don't trust him, I'd be less than a woman, 'cause I can't even walk without him holding my hand. Thank you, Jesus.
Can't even walk,
I can't even
without you holding my hand.
Oh, Jesus,
the mountain is too high,
is too high,
and the valley is too wide.
I'm holding on to your words, Lord.
you are my Father, I am blessed. Your word says you are God's plan for my salvation. Lord, I'm holding on to your promise. I'm holding on to your word. Lord, I'm holding on to you. I'm holding on, holding on to Jesus. Yes, I'm holding on, holding on to my Lord. Lord, I'm holding on, holding on to Jesus. Lord, I'm holding on to his promise. I'm holding on to his word. Lord, I'm holding on to you. You promise you won't forsake me or leave me alone. You promise me you would guide me as you sit at your throne. You promise me that one day I'll see you face to face. Lord, I'm holding on to your promise. I'm holding on to your words. Lord, I'm holding on to you. Yes, I'm holding on, holding on to my Lord. Lord, I'm holding on, holding on to Jesus. Yes, I'm holding on to his promise. I'm holding on to his words. Lord, I'm holding on to you. Promise. I'm holding on to your word. Lord, I'm holding on to you. I'm never gonna let go. I'm holding on to you.
Oh yes, we're holding on to the right hand of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You were saying something just now about choice radio?
Yeah. I see in the studio the choice word. The word choice there is as if you're unpicked. When you are chosen, you're unpicked. It's not, you see, a bungle of ripe mango in the tree. There's a special one among the ripe one.
Amen.
You have a lot of ripe mango, but there's special a special one. Choice.
Yes.
Many different station or radio station, but they're the choice.
Yeah, praise the Lord.
Amen. So receive it by God's grace. I just look and see it. And then you see I love the symbol, the cross, your logo, the cross before the global map, the global map there.
Yes.
Amen. So the cross is for the world. Amen. And it's to the cross men will save, to Christ redemption.
Yes.
Amen. So the fact that the station is on the internet, it's to the world.
Yes.
To the nations of the world. So don't see this station as a station like as usual or like any station. It is choiced. It is choiced.
It's chosen.
Hallelujah. And I'm very happy. And to know it is choice, to know and to confirm it, this is the first radio station I'm coming on in the city.
Praise the Lord.
I walked to other radio station, just walked by. But the first one I enter in. Amen. And come on the here, it's got to be choiced. That when an apostle can come on your radio station, it's got to be choice.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
And I believed we preach the fivefold ministry.
Yes, fivefold ministry.
The apostle, prophet, pastor, evangelist, teacher. Right. We embraced the apostolic and the prophetic. And before I go back home, sometime next week, we're going to have a two-night apostolic and prophetic conference in the city. So we're going to invite everyone out, ministers and everyone, and those who want impartation. Hallelujah. 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 And want to learn more, and you're hungry, you want to know where to go, you want a sense of direction, amen, come to this apostolic and prophetic conference. By Sunday coming, we will have the venue to announce for me.
Okay.
All right? The venue and the time. The time will be 7 p.m. Right? But you will announce the date for me next week, Sunday coming. All right?
All right? No problem.
Good? That's good?
Amen.
Amen?
Amen.
Jesus.
Why me, Lord?
Oh, yeah.
Why me, Lord? What have I ever done to deserve
even one
of the pleasures, ooh, I've known? What did I ever do that was worth loving you for the kindness you've shown? Lord, help me, Jesus. I've wasted it so. Help me, Jesus.
I know.
If you think there's a way I can try to repay all I've taken from you, you know what? Just maybe, Lord, I can show someone else what I've been through myself on my way back to you.
Time to just pray for God's strength, to pray for God's strength for you. Hallelujah. Our God is a present help in the time of trouble. And I want to pray that God will touch your lives out there. Father, in Jesus' name, I lift up your people in the city of New York. I even pray for the president of America. I pray for all those who associate with him. I ask you, Lord God, to direct the path of the government of this country. I ask you, Lord, because the word said Unto us a child is born, and unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder. So the government is under divine control by the Almighty God. And in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray the blessed Redeemer deliverance upon this country. Mighty God, and upon the government of this country, I pray, mighty God, to move by your spirit. I pray, the eternal God, even as I sit in the studio, I feel the anointing to pray right now over this A-wave. I pray in the name of the living God for those who are bound, those who are in shackles, in Jesus' mighty name, to loose. I pray for those who are under drugs. I pray that those who are addicted, mighty God, to drugs and to some other things, that mighty God, by your power divine, you will break them from it. Mighty God, I pray for a wave to open now. The heavens open over this country and even over the city of New York. Mighty God, there's so many things are going on in New York. So many ungodliness and unworthiness. Mighty God, so many ungodliness is taking place. But I ask Mighty God to intervene. Change the hearts of men and women. Let there be a mighty flood of revival. Flood this city with a great waking, a great revival in this city. Mighty God, hallelujah, hallelujah. Your anointing is upon me right now as I pray and intercede for this country. Mighty God, one more time I lift up President Barack Obama, one more time, and his wife, his family. Mighty God, and I pray, God, that you will direct your path for the interest of this country. I pray, mighty God, to touch everyone in the White House, both the oppositions. I ask the Lord to lead them and direct them, because the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. Oh God, it belongs to you. The White House belongs to you. America belongs to you. Oh God, bless America. Let there be a awaken. Let there be a touch. Put your hand upon the city of New York. Hallelujah. Put your hand upon the city of New York. Bring down every idol. Bring down every stubborn spirit. Bring down the bewitcher. Bring down sorcery. Bring down every ungodly behavior. And you be glorified. Take the glory for yourself. It is yours. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. The caller that was calling just called back because he was praying. I didn't want to disturb him. You're free to call back.
Calling the Apostle William. Say hi, Apostle William and Bishop William. Whoa, calling you in. Bless you, madam and sir. These persons are man and woman of God, Apostle and Bishop Williams. Send greetings to them. Those are listening in Jamaica, send greetings to Apostle Jackson, Pastor Lakey, the pastors down there that are working in the vineyard, the leaders, the Brethren of Port Antonio New Hope, the Emmanuel Apostolic Prophetic New Hope Church of God. We bless you up. We bless you up. That worketh
in us. Hallelujah. How many believe it tonight? Somebody turn to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, he's able.
Oh yes, if you know he's able tonight.
He's able. Y'all ready? Exceedingly abundantly above all you could ask for, according to God, 'cause he won't give up on you. He's able. How many believe it tonight? Yeah, yeah. He's able. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, y'all, I need y'all to help me sing. God.
God is able to. Oh, yes, it's 8:31 in the p.m. This is Choice Gospel Radio. Your life, your salvation is your choice. You are listening to Brother Edwin and Bishop Powell. Praise the Lord.
Hello.
Hi, praise the Lord, caller.
Lord, I'm asking for some prayer.
Amen. What's your request?
I just want God to put me back in the fold.
Okay, you are a backslider then.
Yes, sir.
All right, and you want the Lord to bring you back to the fold. So I'm going to come in agreement with your faith. So I'm not going to pray for you. I'm going to pray with you. So upon your request, I'm going to pray with you. Amen, caller?
Yes.
Amen. Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for your daughter, my sister on the other line. We come in agreement. You are the bishop and the shepherd of our soul. Hear your daughter request prayer because she will come back in the fold. Whatever is holding her back, that sevenfold demons, when a person is backslid, a seventh spirit other comes in.
Yes, sir.
Now I break that spirit of darkness. And I release this woman of God to come back in the fold. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, and whatever it takes, and I pray for the provision to be made. I pray for the provision to be made for her. I thank you for releasing this soul. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Yeshua, I thank you and I praise you for releasing this lady. Mighty God, remove that burden right now from her. Burden is removed at Calvary. I thank you for removing that burden. For you are a burden remover. And you are a yoke destroyer. Destroy that yoke and remove her burden. Mighty God, supply her needs at this hour. Supply her needs in Jesus' name. Caller, you're still there?
Yes.
I want you to lift your hand with me where you are. Say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
For saving me
thank
again.
You,
come on, shout it out. Say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, lift your voice. I receive it now in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come on, receive it now. Call his name. Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
Come on, go ahead.
Thank you.
We are with you. We are standing with you on this program this afternoon in the name of Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
There is no distant barrier in prayer. Wherever you are, it reaches right now.
You,
lift your voice, young lady, and say, thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise the name of the Lord. I command your burden. Lift up your hand, young lady, and receive it.
Thank you.
I command your burden to move now.
Thank you.
He's a burden remover. Yes, yes,
thank
ma'am.
You,
that burden that you're carrying, that burden, I pray that God will supply that need. My God, whatever that
thank
burden
you,
is, oh, koshataya bahanda. I command that burden to remove right now. Right now. Right now. Receive it, young lady. I say, receive it now. I command your burden to remove now. Rabakosheke. And I set you free by the power of the Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Jesus.
By the anointing, Jesus breaks the yokes.
Thank you.
Your yoke has been destroyed. Woman of God, will you take up the cross and follow Jesus? It's not too late.
Hallelujah.
Walk out right now, I said. Walk out of sin. Walk out of it. Walk out.
Hallelujah.
I'm not here to question you about your lifestyle. What is it? What is it? You just step up by faith. Make the first step of faith and God will do the rest.
Yes, in Jesus' name.
I don't come with a religious teaching. Because God can allow you to in an unholy environment. And in the unholy environment, he keep you holy.
Yes.
Because he preserved the fresh fish into salt water. So you can into an unholy environment. You don't have anywhere else to go live. Praise God. God can preserve you into that unholy environment. He's a preserver. So I say to this woman of God, wherever you are, wherever you are, you stay there and serve God, and God will bring you out.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Bless the Lord, sister. Wait, which region you are?
Brooklyn.
You're nearby a church? Can we give you our church address?
Yes, sir.
Please meet us at
78 Rockaway, right at the corner of Sumter Street. And if you're looking for a ride, you can call my number. You got a pen?
It's all right. It's not a hurricane.
Okay, when you get a pen, tell me.
I have a pen.
Okay, 646-436.
Yes.
5599. You can call me.
Thank you.
You can call me on Sunday morning, or and I could pick you up and take you to the church, and we could start from there.
Okay.
Amen. And we'll be delighted to see you. Make sure you show up. Amen.
Yes, sir.
And we'll be my brother. Edwin will be announced tonight of Apostolic and Prophetic Conference. He's going to announce the venue. Probably I put the venue at your church. You tell him, may talk to your bishop. Yeah. But you will hear afterward. But we look to see you at church and start from there. We are with you and we will stand with you. Amen.
Yes, sir.
God bless you. Have a wonderful evening.
All right.
Thank you.
May the Lord bless you, my sister. Praise the Lord, caller.
Yes. Good evening.
Good night.
I would like to have a prayer for me.
Bless you, caller. What is your request?
I would like to have a prayer done for me because I'm going through a lot of depression, and I pray to God that I hope to overcome it, but I still need...
All right, stop a minute. You're going through depression, right?
Yes.
All right, let me take you from there. You are a believer in Christ? You baptized already?
Yes, I'm a Catholic.
You believe in God.
I believe in God. Sorry, go ahead.
All right, my Catholic brother, I'm going to come in agreement with your faith. Amen, brother?
Yes.
Father, in Jesus' name, I thank you for my Catholic brother right now. I lift him up before your throne of grace as he goes into this spirit of depression. Mighty God, you are a burden remover, your yoke destroyer. In Jesus Christ's name, I break the spirit of depression right now. Loose his spirit right now. There is a fountain filled with blood drawn from the manual vein. Tonight there's a fountain of water. I pray right now, the Bible said, out of your innermost beam shall flow rivers of living water. And tonight I pray right now that a water will flow in this inside man heart. A water from thy throne will flush out his system right now. And I pray, eternal God, that your presence now will fill him. Mighty God, I pray for transformation for my Catholic brother. And I ask you, mighty God, to take him to deeper depths and higher heights. I pray, mighty God, that his faith will be renewed right now. His mind will be transformed right now. Holy Spirit of the living God. My brother.
Yes.
I want you to lift I want you to lift your hand with me right now where you are. Praise the Lord and say,
I'm lifting my right hand. I'm lifting my hand to you right now.
Yes.
And I'm listening to you.
Praise God. Lift your hand and say, Father.
Father.
In the name of your Son Jesus Christ.
In the name of your Son Jesus Christ.
I receive your healing.
I receive your healing.
I receive your healing.
I receive your healing.
Say it again. I receive your healing.
I receive your healing.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Jesus' name.
Now I speak healing on the inside. For it's not just a physical healing. I speak healing in your spirit, in your mind, mentally. Amen. Hallelujah. Spiritual healing. Praise God. And I bring down the spirit of burden and of depression and oppression. And I call it down by faith in Christ's name.
Amen.
God bless you, brother.
Thank you for My name is Batman, and I just want to say thank you very much.
What's your name?
Batman.
Black man?
Batman.
Batman. All right. Yes, God bless you.
God bless you.
Thank you so very much to both of you.
All right.
And have a wonderful, blessed week.
Yeah, you too.
Thank
you. Thanks.
There
is power in the name of Jesus.
Oh, yes, there is power in the name of Jesus.
Come
when
on.
Demon here, it's a tremble. Hallelujah, Jesus.
There is power in the name of Yeshua to break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There is power.
There is power.
This season, there is an army rising up, Pastor Paul.
Amen, amen.
Yes, it is. In this time, you see, what we used to do before, we cannot do it now. Because time joined near.
And that's why the Lord sent me here, because as a pastor, I have an assignment. And one of my assignments to release impartation, praise God, amen, for the Lord has written up his remnant, he's calling forth his remnant. A new army, a new breath.
Yes.
Praise God. A breath is coming up.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord. And God has sent me with an eye like a high with a eagle high,
yes,
to discern his remnant, to discern who belongs to him and to release them. Amen. And this is what I'm doing on this ear right now, live on the air in the studio, Choice Radio. Choice Radio. Amen. Going forward from Choice Radio, deliverance, freedom, chains are falling. Chains are falling.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And I don't come to give out water to I'm not a psychic. Praise God. I come under the influence and the power of the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
I come to speak what thus said God.
Not thus said man.
Amen. Amen.
Thus said the Lord.
Amen. Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is good.
Yeah, indeed. Indeed.
Yes.
Indeed. Coming out of Choice Radio Studio. My God.
Yeah, because I'll tell you where I came from and where I is now. In the let me take this call. Praise the Lord, caller.
Yes, DJ Vibes.
Yes.
Yes, this is Batman speaking.
Uh-huh.
Just call to say good night.
Good night.
Huh?
Yes, I know it was you. Yes. I know it was you.
Yes, yes. I just want to say to all of my fellow listeners, praying is a very powerful thing.
Amen.
And I've been through a lot these past couple of months, but I know that when I pray, I know that the Lord is listening to you, me, and everybody else. When you all go to bed tonight, pray. When you get up in the morning, pray. Because nobody does not know what tomorrow, what the future holds. And I just wanted to pass on that knowledge to the people who are listening.
Amen. All right?
Yes, amen to you.
All right, thank brother. You. Yes.
Just a reminder of tonight, scripture thoughts from Psalms 24, verses 9 and 10. Go through it, 9 and 10. This is what the Lord is speaking into the heart of this city this afternoon. Those who are going to struggle, you may at the gate of hell. You're going to say to your gate of hell, lift up your head, O ye gates, for the King of glory is about to come to for you. Is the Lord of hosts, Jehovah Sabaoth, Lord of war. And you can achieve that through prayers, as the caller just said a while ago, to prayer. The effective fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much. And we are here to intercede for somebody tonight. Praise God. Pray you through to take you to the next level. We are here for you. God bless you.
Oh yes, it's 8:48. We just have a few minutes in the building. So if you want your prayers, you can call. If you're lost and you want to be found, we can bring you back. Holiness, we can pray you.
This is what I love.
The prayer to salvation. The same what we have, we want to share it with you. We want to share this peace what we have. You know, the things I used to have, the eager I used to have a long time for, I don't have it no more because I'm a new man in Christ. I think 2 Corinthians 17.
Talk about
if any
man be in Christ. Yes, 2 Corinthians. If any man be in Christ, is a new
creature.
Yes, new creature.
All
things
are
passed away.
And behold, all things
yes.
have become new.
Yes.
So the things you used to have the eager for, you don't have it no more. Because every time you're thinking to go to do this, mm-hmm. you remember you're serving now. I live in Christ. I live in God.
Mm.
However you want to put it. You don't have this zeal for that. All what you want to be holy. Because you know if you slip, sometimes you go out and you take a chance. You don't know if you're coming back.
That's right.
You know? So we all have to be mindful of what we're doing. And remember who we're serving. Because we all want to see the glory of God. We want to walk on the street of gold. Everybody want to do that. But if we ain't doing the right thing and we ain't loving our brothers and sisters, we cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. So we got to practice an ought to love our earthly brothers and sisters, and then we could see. Because if we ain't loving our brothers and sisters, we cannot love God, ain't it?
We can see.
That's what we're talking about.
That's right.
So we have to try our best.
Love first, we can see, right?
Yes, yes. We always have to do that.
Yes, yes.
And let our heart be clean.
And when you love who you can see, you get able to love better, more. Him, God, who you can't see.
Yes.
So we are the test. We are his test.
Yes.
So we cannot love one another. You can't say you love God. You make him a liar and the truth is not in you. You deceive your own self.
Absolutely right. Another preacher, I just talking
no,
a little.
Preach it, man. You're preaching. Hey, you're preaching. Once you're proclaiming the word, you're preaching.
Yes.
You're preaching because you're proclaiming the word.
And that might, I mightn't be like, you know, fire like, you know, but, you know, in my own
in
way,
right.
I'm just doing what I got to do for the Lord. And I give him all the glory.
And little is much. Come
yes,
on.
Yes.
Little is much when God is in it.
Amen.
And do not despise small things. Small beginning. Good things always come sometime in small.
Small package. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Okay, that person hang up.
Huh?
I said the person hung up. Call back, caller.
So we have about 8 minutes in the studio.
Yes.
All right, caller. We are here for you for the next 8 minutes. Praise the Lord to pray with you. Amen. And to share your concern.
Caller?
Yes, off the air, please.
Hold on, I can do you off the air now because we have a few minutes. You can call me back after. Let me take this other call. Praise the Lord. Caller, listen to your phone and not your radio.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Yes, I would like to ask for the pastor to repeat what Sam says.
Okay, bless you, caller. Psalms 24, verses 9 and 10. That's
and I would like you to pray for me, please.
Oh, all right. What is your request?
Well, my request, I don't know. My mind is not stable. One time I say I'm going to church, next time I'm not going. I just get a double mind feeling, and I don't like the feeling.
All right, so I know exactly what to pray about. Okay, the word of God say a double-minded person cannot please God. He's unstable in his all his way. So that's a spirit that's not of God. All right, the Bible also said in Isaiah that he will keep them in perfect peace whose mind are stayed in him. And the Bible also said in Romans that to be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So let me pray with you. Come in agreement with me right now. Gracious Father, I thank you right now for this sister on the other line. Every time she want to go to church, something is holding her back. She have a double mind. Now in Jesus' name, I break the spirit and I speak one mind. I speak the mind of Christ in Jesus' name. And I pray for this lady that the Holy Spirit will give her a sense of direction in life. Mighty God, minister into her spirit right now in Jesus' name. Are you still there?
I'm still here.
Lift your hand with me and say, Jesus.
Jesus.
Call that name loud. Say, Jesus.
Jesus.
I thank you for deliverance.
I thank you for delivering me.
Touch my mind.
Touch my mind.
Say it again. Touch my mind.
Touch my mind.
In Jesus' name, upon your prayer right now, with your prayer, I come in agreement with your prayer. In Jesus' name, Father, pray you touch her mind right now. I ask the Lord to deliver her from fear. The Lord is saying into my spirit right now, lady, there's a fear in you. What caused that fear?
I don't know.
Am I right? Am I right?
Yes.
There's
yes,
a fear. Listen yes. to this. Mm-hmm. The Bible said, let me give this word quickly because we soon come out of the studio. The Bible said, he had not given you the spirit of fear, but of love, power, and of a sound mind. Sound mind. Now, in Jesus' name, I want you to quote that word, amen, time and time again, in the night and in the day. That word that said, he had not given you the spirit of fear. Keep on saying, say, devil, Jesus Christ have not given me the spirit of fear. Right, because fear is not of God. Any fear you should have is godly fear. Fear God. Yes. God bless you. We are running out of time. Praise the Lord. Let's give somebody a chance. We love you. I will keep praying for you. God bless you.
God bless you too. God love you too.
Amen.
To worship you, I live. To worship you, I live to worship you. Oh.
Oh, to the caller that just called, I don't know if you have a church to go to, but if you need a church to go to, we located at 78 Rockaway, right on the corner of Sumter Street. And if you want to go to the church, you can call my number, 646-436-5599. You can call me. I will come pick you up and take you to the church.
That's a wonderful caller. The Lord is beginning to do something new in your life now. So wake up, arise, and go forth.
So long as you're getting a ride, you cannot say you ain't going. I take you there and bring you back right in front of your door.
That's awesome.
You don't have to pay us. The ride is free. But salvation is real.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I love the part that you said, though, you don't have to pay for salvation.
It's real.
Right? You never said salvation is free. I hear a lot of preachers say that salvation is free. But the truth is it has been paid for.
Yes. Amen.
Christ paid for it.
Praise the Lord, caller.
Yes, I need to get your number, please.
Okay.
Go again.
You got a pen?
Yes.
646.
Mm-hmm.
436.
436, yes.
5599. Yes, and put Brother Edwin by it. So you can't miss it.
Thank you. I call you on Saturday.
Yes. Call me anytime. My phone never shut down.
Okay,
all
right.
Amen.
When you have no words left, just say, oh, oh, oh,
oh. Oh, yes. And Pastor Powell number for Jamaica is 1-876-475-3847. Pastor Powell, A. Powell. Oh, oh. Hallelujah. So we go wind it down now. It's 8:59. So we got Pastor Powell, you want to pray us out again?
Amen. Thank you for having me. Praise the Lord. And I have another week left. So I'll be probably back here next week. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. To God be the glory. I praise you, God, and I thank you for those callers. And I ask you to touch their lives and restore. Thank you, mighty God, for our brother in the studio. Anoint this studio. Anoint the A-Wave. Anoint this studio. Anoint the A-Wave. And I thank you for protection over him in this ministry. In Jesus' name. God bless you.
God bless you. You have a blessed week and catch you back here on, I think Saturday. Yeah, Saturday, Friday, whatever. Amen. So stay tuned. Do not turn off the radio. We have something coming up for you.